Now, I don't know about you, but I have to ask myself, where was Kane that night? Did The Undertaker have him locked up somewhere? Did The Undertaker decide to go down to the Sears men's store and say, I'll have a Kane suit, please? Did the Undertaker work in conjunction with his brother Kane? How did that happen? I simply asked that question last Monday on Raw. Take a look. Are you in cahoots with your brother Kane?
Uh-oh. Wait a minute.
You can go to hell.
Let's continue on upon our reflections. In a stroke of genius, it came to me. I'd find the answer last Monday. I would order indeed a rematch of the tag team title match in which the Outlaws would once again face Mankind and Kane. However, I would have two enforcers on the outside of the ring in addition to the regular referee, one enforcer being The Undertaker and the other being Stone Cold. Now let's take a look and show you what happens now when Kane is about to be pinned 1, 2, 3 by the Road Dogg. Watch what happens when Austin tries to count to three. Let's take a look.
Inside cradle. That'll be it. That'll be all.
There's
Austin. Wait a minute. Undertaker. Undertaker. Pull Austin out.
That answers your question. That's got to answer your question right there. The Undertaker and Kane.
Anyone getting my drift? All right, let's continue on with the reflections then. The Road Dogg was about to be pinned. The Undertaker decided to count his brother to victory. Take a look.
Here we go!
There!
That should be all right there.
The Road Dogg's ass is calling the
spot.
And then there was just one more piece of evidence, if you will. We had, after that situation, Undertaker and Austin face to face. What was going to happen? We were going to have an explosion, but watch what happens. Undertaker's brother Kane wipes out Austin. Look.
The Undertaker and Austin are the enforcers for this rematch.
And now, here to answer my question, one last opportunity to answer my question. Is he, the Undertaker, in cahoots with his brother Kane? I give you the Undertaker. I'm disappointed in you. We've just seen the reflections. Now let's talk about respect. Because when you answered me when I asked you the question about being in cahoots, and you told me to go to hell, and quite frankly, what you did was you hurt my feelings. To be humiliated publicly by someone that I'm responsible for giving the opportunity to superstardom, that didn't make me feel good at all. So therefore, let's talk about respect. If in fact you are to be the champion you can be, if you're going to be the champion you really want to be, one for the ages, then you're going to have to start showing respect for the proper people. Let me tell you something. You can't do it alone. You can't do it just with the support of these people. You need me.
That's right.
Last week, your actions were disrespectful, disparaging, and insolent. And I won't take it anymore.
Whoa. I think McMahon's getting a little carried away now.
You've got to learn to show the proper respect, and if you do, you won't be a flash in the pan champion like Stone Cold Steve Austin is destined to be. Just listen to reason. So therefore, Undertaker, I ask you one last time. Are you and your brother Kane in cahoots?
Undertaker better answer now.
Answer me, damn it!
Ooh, he's definitely getting carried away.
All right. Okay. Have it your way then. Let's talk about retribution. All right? For those uninitiated, retribution is revenge. And if you are to learn a lesson and to be a champion of the ages, sometimes you have to learn the hard lessons and you got to learn the hard way. And believe me, with what I'm about to teach you, it'll hurt me just as much as it's going to hurt you.
But McMahon's like,
because I don't want to do this. You're forcing me into do this, but by God, if you're going to be the champion I think you can be, then you're going to learn a lesson tonight.
For your own good.
What's he mean?
In this very ring tonight, Undertaker, you're over in this corner, and in the other corner will be both Mankind and your brother Kane. Ding, ding, ding.
That's what he means.
All this because the Undertaker told Mr. McMahon to go to hell last week?
And now, Undertaker, you may take your leave.
McMahon's vindictive, in case you didn't know, JR.
I said leave. Wait a minute. Just before you go, just one thing I want to get off my chest. It's what you said to me last Monday. Undertaker, you can go to hell.
Oh, my. Look at the look on the Undertaker.
Hold it! Hold it!
Oh, the Undertaker's got McMahon.
Get out of there! No!
He got a tombstone! A choke slam! A choke slam! The owner's been... Oh, here comes Patterson and Briscoe. The reinforcements are here.
Get in there, Briscoe! No, no!
Oh!
Commissioner!
A commissioner of the WWF! Has just snapped, and
I think Mr. McMahon's neck is just there. He's had neck surgery for Pete's sake. Look at this. You've gone too far now, Undertaker. This is ridiculous. Who does he think he is? Cannot do that to the owner of the World Wrestling Federation. Look at this. His neck is hurt.
What a hell of a way to end a board meeting right here. Regardless, ladies and gentlemen, a handicap match right here tonight. Undertaker versus Kane and Mankind.
Right, and we're going to finally find out that I was right. Kane and The Undertaker are in cahoots. You'll find that out.
And ladies and gentlemen, we'll find out hopefully what Stone Cold Steve Austin has to say about it. I'll be talking to him a little bit later.
Wait a minute, JR. Look at this. They're trying to help me. Oh, my gosh. Pat Patterson, you've caught the idiot. He trip on our Briscoe. He's not Mr. McMahon down. Get up.
We got problems here. Yeah, big problems, no doubt about it.
Look out!
Problems in the White House.